Hi, I'm Paulshinn. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, the most boomer-oriented car channel in all of YouTube, and proud of it. This episode marks a milestone in this channel. This channel has reached 10,000 subscribers. That means 10,000 people have clicked the subscribe button right down here and become subscribers to this channel. And why not? It's free, costs you nothing. And if you click subscribe and subscribe to this channel, karma will take notice. Your Model A will not break down. That's just kind of how it works. But anyway, what does that mean? That means thanks to you, 10,000 subscribers is quite a milestone for YouTube sites to reach. It's kind of a big deal. It's a big deal to me. I see the importance of this. I feel the gravity of it. I understand the obligation I have to you to continue this channel and to keep the information flowing. And that's exactly what I intend to do. I'm so appreciative of everyone who's taken the time to subscribe. Thank you so much. This is amazing. So to celebrate 10,000 subscribers today, I'm going to be doing a 10,000 mile service on this car. So every 500 miles, and I've covered that in a previous video, we have to lube the chassis, and depending on if you have an oil filter or not, change the oil, go over the fluids. Every 1,000 miles, you're changing, you know, training rear end, you're checking all that, and lubricating, doing all the things you did on the 500 mile service, and it escalates out. 5,000 miles, you're doing all that, plus you're doing XYZ. So this is a 10,000 mile service, which is essentially the 5,000 plus a couple extra things. So we're gonna be going over all the fluids in the car. My wife is going to be helping by showing what she does to change the transmission rear end fluids on our four-door sedan. And that was in a video right here that she shot earlier this year where she did the complete service on our four-door. She'll be sharing that, and I'll also be going through the front end on this car. I'm gonna be repacking the front wheel bearings. We're gonna pull the floorboards out, and we're going to lubricate the throwout bearing carrier, which is inside under the inspection plate in the clutch housing. And while we've got the floorboards out, I'm going to go ahead and change the battery in this car. Not that it necessarily needs it right now, but I just like reliability. The battery in here is getting a little long in the tooth. I've got a brand new Optima 6 volts sitting on the shelf. Figured why not? It's a good time to do it while the floorboards are out anyway. Then we're just going to give the car once over, make sure everything's tight and ready to go. So anyway, this is an amazing video, and it's just a tremendous thing to imagine 10,000 subscribers. I still can't get over it. I never thought this channel was going to get that kind of response, and I'm really humbled. Thank you so much for this. It's amazing. So without further ado, I guess we should get started. So welcome back to my shop, where safety is always the highest priority. And you'll see I have a helper today. This is Kenny. This is a kid I met when he was about 8 years old, I think. And Tina and I pretty much adopted him, so he's like an adoptive son. In fact, this is the kid I gave my truck to when he graduated high school. He's in his mid-20s now. He's been turning wrenches for a couple of years. He works as a full-time diesel equipment mechanic. And I think he makes more money than I do now. But anyway, he loves turning wrenches with me on the old cars. I think the first time he turned a wrench with me, he was still in high school. We were working on probably the four-door or something. And he instantly took to it and then just took off on a career of auto mechanics and went to trade school and went to Caterpillar school. And now he's the man he is today. So, yeah, I don't mind having him help me on the car. It's great. And I think if you know a young person, you should introduce them to working on Model A's along with you also, because you wouldn't believe the rewards. It really pays off. Now with the floorboards totally out of the way, we have full access to the inspection plate over the throwout bearing. So just loosen the two screws, slide the plate up. Don't take the screws all the way out. Here you can see the throwout bearing. Use a rag to wipe any dirt away from the grease fitting so you don't put grease in it. Get your Model A adapted grease fitting, put it on there. It might take you a try or two. It took me two tries to get it. Remember, you're not actually putting grease into the throwout bearing itself. It's a sealed bearing. All you're greasing is the carrier, the part that slides back and forth on the transmission shaft every time you push the clutch in. That's all you're greasing here. So you don't have to overdo it, just a little bit. And when you're done, just slide the cover back on, tighten the screws, you're all set. After daily driving this car for a year, it got a little bit dirty, so I went ahead and wiped all this down when I was done. Now it was time to swap out the battery. I put this battery in sometime in 2019, but it wasn't a new battery when I installed it, and I didn't really know how much longer this battery was going to last, and I had a brand new Optima sitting on the shelf, so I decided to go ahead and swap it out. So as you can see, the first thing I do is disconnect the ground side of the battery. The reason for that is if you're working on the hot side of the battery and you accidentally touch ground and short the battery out, you can weld your wrench to it. That's never a good thing. But if you're doing the ground side first and release that from the battery, there's no way you can make big sparks when you finally work on the other side. I really like the 6-volt Optima batteries. Man, they put out a lot of current when you need it.
This extra wire right here is extra ground. I just have that wire running to the engine block. I just like to make sure my engine is good and grounded. Instead of trying to ground it through the motor mounts or the fuel line or something like that, I just like having a separate ground on it. It helps the starter turn over faster too. Short out the battery while you're doing this, that would suck. Feels like it's tight. All right. Got all this stuff where it's in the right spot. All right, floorboards.
As you can see, I gave in to my OCD and cleaned everything underneath the car and cleaned the floorboards before reinstalling. Assuming your floorboards aren't warped, they should go back in really easily. Luckily, mine fit perfectly still. Well, the hard part isn't necessarily getting the floorboards in or even the rubber mat. The real hard part is getting the little rubber boots back into place and to fit underneath the mat. The rubber boots that I added to the emergency brake lever and the overdrive lever really snazzy up the inside of the car, but it really makes putting the floor mat back in a real pain. Now that the floor is all back in and looking perfect, now we need to focus our attention on one of the most overlooked lubrication points in the Model A, and that is the steering column. All of these shafts where they go through need to be lubricated. I've taped my flashlight here so you can look down in here with me. So what we need to do is take our oiler with some synthetic motor oil and just put it right in here and put a few drops of oil on the bushing where the steering shaft goes through, and then again right where the throttle lever goes down and through, and then on the other side where the spark advance lever is, and get a few drops on those. Throw out bearing mechanism, done. Now, we're gonna pack front wheel bearings. First thing we gotta do is jack up the car, pull the wheels off, and we'll get started on that. I didn't think we needed a step-by-step tutorial on how to take wheels off, so it's the same old thing. Just loosen the lug nuts while the wheel's on the ground, jack it up in the air, and then take them off the rest of the way. Nothing special. Now the next step is to get the drum off. First thing we got to do is we got to take this cotter pin loose. Then we're going to loosen up the brake shoes. Cutter pins out. Now I'm going to back off the brake adjusters 5 clicks. I'm going to do that both sides and I pull them apart. Then I got to remember to go 5 clicks back the other way. That'll put the brakes right back into adjustment. I won't lose anything. Five clicks. Now I got to grab my giant wrench. I already know I'm going to catch a lot of heck for this, but these are the exact tools my grandfather used working on his Model A. So I'm using my grandfather's tools working on Model A's just like him. So yeah, it's a family tradition. So I just pull the drum back a little bit, then push it back on. Then I've got the outer bearing race and the washer right there in my hands. Now I can pull the drum all the way off, and then I have access to the inner bearing right here. To get the inner bearing out, I just use a couple of screwdrivers. I know this isn't the super cool way to do it, but it has never failed me. There we go, the inner bearing. Now we're going to repack these bearings. While you've got the drum off, this is a good opportunity to inspect your brake shoes, your brake pads, make sure that everything is in good shape, all the tracks and everything are in good shape. Check your drum, make sure there's no grooves in it. These brakes I put on here a little over 10,000 miles ago, and they're still holding up well. I've got the bonded brake shoes and the cast iron brake drums, and they work fantastic. So for wheel bearings, I just use good old-fashioned Timken wheel bearing grease, nothing fancy. And although there are machines and tools and things to pack bearings for you, nothing, in my opinion, works as good as the way your high school auto shop teacher told you, and that is to pack them by hand. So the way your high school auto shop teacher told you to pack bearings is still the best way, in my opinion. Get a bunch of grease in the palm of your hand and just start packing it in there. Yeah, there's tools and machines that can pack bearings for you, but I still think the way your auto shop teacher told you how to do it in high school is the best way. I've never had a problem with Model A wheel bearings getting dry on me, ever. I always pack them by hand. So really all we're doing is we're getting grease into each of these rollers and in between the surfaces of the bearing here. And you can tell when the bearing's fully packed, because when you push on it, grease comes out the other side. Then you know that this bearing is completely packed and ready to go. Now with the bearing fully packed, I'm gonna put the inner bearing back on. Just pushes right into place. And I'll pack the outer bearing next. All right, the inner bearing is fully packed, ready to go back in. So I'll set that aside and get it ready. Get some clean gloves on. Okay, with everything thoroughly inspected, I'm really happy with the way this is turning out and the way the inside looks. Time to put the drum back on. That'll sit there like that. Now I'll take the inner bearing, or the outer bearing rather, and the washer here. Make sure that the slot on the washer goes into the slot on the axle. Wipe off the excess grease here. Okay, now put the castle nut on. I know there's a little bit of controversy about how tight to get wheel bearings. I'm going to show you the method I use, and I've never had any trouble with it. I'm sure the forum experts will tell me that I'm wrong in 100 different ways. But the trick is to tighten it down until you start feeling a little tension on the drum, okay? The main thing is you have to turn it, all right? Don't just tighten it without turning the drum. You want to feel this and feel how tight this is. Keep going until it starts to feel tight and then go a little more. Okay, it feels a little tight. Now I'm going to rotate it several times here. And you kind of feel it start to loosen up. It means those bearings are seating. If you were to just tighten this right now without spinning this and call it good, it would take no time at all and this would be super loose. A lot of wobble on front ends is caused by loose wheel bearings, by the way. So now this is loosened up quite a bit. I'm going to tighten it more. Not a lot, just a little. It feels a little tight, but not much. Okay, I'm going to tighten it just a tad more. See how it loosens right up? Okay, now that it feels kind of tight and it's not loosening up anymore, now I know that those bearings are seated. So now I'll back off to where this feels pretty good. A little more. There we go. That feels pretty good. All right, now I just got to get it to where a cotter pin's going to line up. That might be too loose right there. Let me see. Nope, that feels pretty good, actually. I'm going to call it good right there. So I know a lot of people reuse cotter pins. Don't ever reuse a cotter pin. They're cheap. Get a new cotter pin. Always. Please. Do me a favor. Get a new cotter pin every time. All right, cotter pin installed. That feels pretty good. Now we're going to set our brakes back. Remember, 5 clicks. Now our brakes should be right back where they were. Now we're ready to put the wheel back on. All right, let's get this wheel back on. Couple pro tips for you. If you wrap electrical tape around your four-way, you won't scratch the rims here, the wheels, when you put your wheels back on. The other thing is, a lot of people, I use paint on my wheels, but a lot of people use powder coat on their Model A wheels. And then when they put the lug nuts on, the lug nuts tend to chip away the powder coat or it breaks it off. That's easy to fix on your lug nuts if you have the proper Model A lug nuts anyway. You can put just a little tiny bit of grease right on the very edge here before you put your lug nuts on, and then you won't chip the powder coat off of your wheels. And because the only thing more boring than watching paint dry is watching someone put a wheel on a car, I went ahead and sped this up for you out of respect for your time. Once I've got the car back on the ground, then I'll go ahead and torque the lug nuts the rest of the way. So what I'm going to do is head to the other side of the car, and I'm going to pack that wheel bearing and inspect those brakes. While that's going on, I'm going to go back in time a little bit, and I'm going to take you to a video my wife did where she's going to show you how to check and change the transmission and rear end fluid in the Model A. If everything in your Model A fits right and the bearings are in good shape, your fluids in your rear end and your transmission probably won't get very dirty very fast. So mostly we just check the fluids to make sure that they're still clean. If they are, we leave them until the next service. I did a full video last year on how to change all the fluids in the Model A. I'll go ahead and link to that in the description below if you want a step-by-step detailed description on how to change the fluids in the rear end of the transmission. But otherwise, just check the fluids at the 10,000 mile mark, make sure they're clean and full. That's pretty much good enough.
Okay, that should be good. Clean up my mess. Now I'll check the transmission oil. Nothing yet. Oh. So maybe it needs just a little bit. It's a little tricky, so I'm going to put my finger here, just like Paul showed me. Let's see if I can get through. through here with my small little hands. I know if I make a mess, he's gonna laugh at me. All right, I'll put this here. This has definitely got to be the most awkward one to do. Let's see if I can get this back down here correctly. So I can get my finger on it. Ah, there we go. Get it back up. There we go. And I'll try sticking my finger in there again. Oh yeah, nice and full. All right, put this lid back on because I know how clumsy I am. Odd at this angle. I get confused of what way I'm supposed to go. Just to make sure.
Well, you've got the front wheels off. Now's the perfect time to check the fluid level in the shocks. At 10,000 miles, you go all the way around, check all four corners. So get your 7/16 wrench out. Now take your flashlight, look down in there. And you should just see fluid just above where the shaft is, below the threads. I have a little bottle here filled with hydraulic oil that I use to top these off. You don't want it to be overflowing, you just want it filled to about just underneath the threads. Since I rebuilt these shocks last year, they haven't been leaking, so this thing isn't really low. None of them have been low yet, but it's a good idea at 10,000 miles to go around all four corners of the car and make sure that the shocks are full of fluids. As far as adjusting shocks, that's another video entirely. It isn't so critical that the shocks have some particular adjustment on them. The main thing is just to make sure that all the shocks are adjusted the same. Okay, I've got this side all done, ready to go. Now it's time to drop the car back down to the ground and torque the lug nuts. After the Model A is back on its own wheels, I like to slide back under the car and just give everything one more once over and make sure I didn't forget anything. Well, there you have it. One 10,000 mile service in the books. Thank you so much for joining me today, and hopefully we'll do this again soon. Before we go, there's a few people I really want to thank. December, some donations came in that helps keep this channel running, helps keep fluids on the shelves and some parts we can put on cars and show how things run. Thank you so much for sending donations. Thomas Looney, first of all, thank you so much. And Heron, I didn't get first. Is that first last name or is that like a single name, Heron? Thank you so much. Jeff Crummy, appreciate your donation. Very helpful. William Donnelly, thank you for your donation and the monthly reoccurring donations from Replications Company. Thank you so much. Special people like you are what are keeping this channel running, keeping the information flowing on how to keep these amazing cars on the road. So, man, I can't wait to get this thing out, but it's all stormy and windy and rainy and gross outside. So I think I'm going to go in the house for some hot cocoa first, and I don't know, maybe it'll clear up later and we'll take the car for a spin. Thanks so much, and I'll see you on the next video. Thanks again to everybody who took the time to subscribe to this channel. 10,000 subscribers. I know, that is a big deal. I won't let you down. Thank you so much for making me YouTube's Model A guy. I'll see you on the next video.